Hey, hey, Kappa. How's it going? Coach Beth here. We're going to be heading into the advanced ABCs of bike safety. So hopefully you've already watched the basic video. If not, go ahead back on the Google folder and go ahead and watch the basic video of the ABCs. Today we're going to be covering advanced ABCs. So remember, air, Beth, chain, right? Just kidding. Air, brakes, chain. You know Coach Ashley's gonna say her A stands for Ashley, but we know that B stands for Beth. So what we're gonna be doing in this video is really reviewing what to do if you have a flat tire. And I'm gonna talk a little bit about some of the equipment that you should always have whenever you go out for a bike ride. So first thing that you want is to have a bike pump. And there is a really big bike pump that you probably have in your garage. You don't want to be carrying this on your bike. So there's other options. There's a really nice small bike pump. I like this one because it gives me a gauge here. And you can attach this to your bike or put it in a book bag. Another option is a very small CO2 tank here, which you put in and you can fill your tire very quickly with this by just pressing it. Compared to the smaller one, you have to pump, pump, pump. So this is really nice. So always some way to fill your tire up when you're out riding. The other thing that you want is a spare tube, right? So you can get a spare tube and hold it in your book bag, or you can get a bike sack to be able to put it on. And then you want what's called tire levels. And these really help go ahead and take the tire off of the rim. So they usually come in a set of three, and that's what you would like. And then also a tube repair kit is a really good thing to have, especially if you just have a small hole, you can quickly repair it and get back going. Or if you only brought one tube and you already went through your tube and you got another flat, it's really good to have a tube repair kit with you. So this is gonna cover having to change your tire. I wanna show you, there's two different types of tubes that you can have. There's the very standard, which is called a Strater. And this one is wide, has a wide tip to it, and it usually has a plastic knob on top. And you would just go ahead and put the pump on here, press your lever down or up, depending on what kind of pump you have to pump this up. The other one is called a Presta, and a Presta tube is usually more for more advanced or high level performance bikes. And this one here sometimes has a black cap or a clear cap, but it also has a locking mechanism. So you actually have to undo this very tip of the tube to be able to release the pin to be able to pump up your tire. So first thing you want to figure out is really what kind of tube you have. The nice thing is that many pumps these days will actually have the availability to be able to pump with a Strater or a Presta valve. So you can have one pump that covers both of your different valves. All right, so let's head over to the bike here. I have two different bike examples. So I have this one here, which is my Presta. So you can see here, I have the black cap on here. So I'd have to take this off to be able to access the tube if my tire was low. It's pretty pumped up right now. And then this pin here, I would never be able to pump it unless I release this pin, because this is another mechanism that really locks it. So I'd have to screw that little nut up to the top, and then that releases the pin, which allows then me to be able to pump that tire. But most of you probably have a Strater, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you what that looks like. Go ahead and change bikes. Right, so this here is a very typical tube that you would see. Has a black cap on it. So you want to twist that cap off to be able to access the stem of the tube. Once you have that access, you're going to make sure that you're on your Strater, which is the larger one of the two. You can see this one's really small. I want to put it on this large one here. And it's really, really important that when you put your pump onto your tube stem, that you really get it on all the way so that you're able to pump actual air into the tire and not just into the piping of it. So sometimes you have to wiggle, and if your tire is really flat, you have to kind of squeeze it to keep that stem up and really get it as far down as you can. You shouldn't be able to see really any of the stem part. Once you're there, you're going to lock it in place. Most pumps you lock by lifting the tab up. Some are opposite. Some you put on with the tab up and you lock it by bringing it down. Then I can see in my lovely dirty PSI valve here. So we're at about 52 PSI. And the nice thing with most tires, if we look around the side, this is going to tell you what your wheel length and your thickness is. So this is a 26 inch by 1.95 inches. So when you need to buy a new tube, you're gonna be looking for a tube that is the Strator 26 by 1.95. Then it tells you around the rim, up here we can see your pressure, your air pressure should be between 40 and 65. Okay, so we're at about 50, not bad. It's pretty flat though. I wouldn't want to ride on that. I'd sit on it and it would go like that. So let's get it up to about 65. So always test out. Make sure that when you pump, it should be somewhat easy. If you're getting stuck here and you're not able, that means that you don't have this all the way on. So you got to unrelease it, press it back, and really try to get it on. So I'm going to go ahead and start pumping it. Oh, actually, this was empty. I was reading the wrong red dial. This was all the way at zero. So it's going to take a few pumps to get us up to around 65. And it should be pretty hard tire. You shouldn't be able to really squeeze it too much. And then you know it's full. Get a good arm workout here. All right, now we're back up to 50. Moving forward. Good, and we are at 65 right there. So I was reading this, I forgot my dial. I can change it to set it. And it's the black one here that shows me what the tire is. So you can set this to be able to remind you of where you want it to be, right at 65. Right now, I can go and feel this tire. It is super hard. That is a good tire there. Looks nice. I'm gonna release this. You're always gonna release a little bit of air. That's okay. So I just undo that and then quickly try to wiggle it off. There we go. So then we don't lose any air. You always double check it after you do that. All right, so that's the easy part, is when you just have a tire that's low in air. The hard part is when you actually have a hole in your tire. What do you need? The cap? Mm-hmm. So if we had a hole in the tire, first make sure you put your cap back on, keep it nice and sealed. So if we had a hole in this tire, we're gonna actually have to take the tire off of the bike. So for this bike here, in order to take the tire off, it has what's called a quick release, which is really nice. So you're able to just pull this open and then you're gonna hold this other nut here and be able to loosen it up. It's called a quick release to be able to take the tire off. Some will have two nuts on the side, so you actually have to get wrenches and hold each other. But many bikes nowadays have the quick release, which is nice. But the hard part is after you loosen this up, most of the time your brakes are a lot closer because of the rim and aren't going to let you pull your tire off. So you have to figure out how to release your brakes to be able to take the tire off. This mechanism right here is nice because it has a quick release. So if I actually squeeze the brake together, I can go ahead and pop this side off, which then fully opens the ability to take my tire off. So now you can see both the brake pads are out of the way. I can then lift up the bike and take the tire completely off. All right, so let's show you a different brake pattern. So this is my other bike here. So again, Here's the quick release, which is really nice. I can undo it and then use this side, hold it, spin it. But this has a different brake release. So on this one, this actually loosens up the brake. So I can open that fully open and then the tire can go through the brake. Really important when you put the tires back on that you adjust your brake so it's not rubbing your rim, but is enough that it still will squeeze and work for your brakes. So again, this is the hardest part, is to figure out what mechanism your brake has to be able to take the tire off. Okay, now I'm gonna walk you through how to actually change your tire. All right, we are back at it. So we're gonna be working on actually how to change the tube of your tire. So I'm actually using a wheelchair tire because it is flat. So I do actually need to change this from my wheelchair that I have. So now that the tire's off, just like if you took it off from the bike, what we're gonna do is we're gonna work on getting the tire off of the rim so that we can pull the tube out from it. So first thing, some of the tubes have a little locking nut. So I wanna just take this off to make sure I can pull the tube out of it. If it's not 100% flat, it's usually best to also flatten the tube inside. That'll help you. So there is a pin that's on the inside. You can press that down, but this, you can see, this is totally flat. All right, so from here, we're gonna be taking these tools. Again, really important to have these because they really help take the tire off of the rim without putting any nicks or cuts or spurs in your rim, which could then pop another tire. So many people say, oh, you can just use a screwdriver. A screwdriver, you're gonna put metal on metal and really mess up your rim. Also, after you change your tire, there's a good possibility using a screwdriver that you're gonna pop your brand new tube. So these are really nice because they're not gonna pop a tire. So what you wanna do is to kind of pull the tire away and you wanna grab the inside here of the tube and you're gonna pull it out and over. And what's nice about these is once you have it out and over, you can actually hook it on to a rim spoke and it keeps it out for you. That's why you have three. So then I move a little bit further down and I do the same thing. I reach in and try to grab just the tire. And again, wheelchair tires are definitely a lot tighter than your bike tires. But if this is your first time doing it, it does take a while to figure out how to get this off. So again, getting in there. Sometimes as you spread a little bit further out helps. There you go. Sometimes you want to make sure you don't grab both sides of the tube. Come on, work with me. Let's try to go a little bit further down. Almost. Let me go ahead and move this one. Sometimes you can sneak it down, grab another one. I might have to demo on the bike tire because this is too tight. a lot of work. All right, so what did I do after I had them locked in here on my spokes? Is once you get about two in and locked in, you can then put it in and then just kind of run this along the rim and it'll pop out the rest of the tire for you. Whoa, wait till you see when I have to try to put this tire back on. It's even worse. All right, so nice thing is now I have the entire inner part of the tire off the rim. So you're gonna go find where the stem of the tube is, and you can reach in and grab your flat tube. And then I like to push the stem back through, get it past that hole to be able to get it out. Maybe nothing seems to want to work here. There we go. All right. And then you pull your tube all the way out. All right. This is your tube with the hole in it. So you can patch this if you want and save it as a reserve. Whoa, I'm sweating. Many times they really aren't good to use again unless in emergencies. So I have a couple on hand, but for the most part, I usually just buy a new one for a replacement. All right, so now we are on to our new tube. So this is a 26 by 1 inch to 1.25 inches. So again, this is what you're looking when you buy a new tube. You can get it at Walmart, Amazon, you name it. Comes pretty flat, right? So it's nice to keep it this way because where the valve is, this is where you want this line to really be on the inside so that you're not twisting your tube at all around. And again, take the cap off so that you're able to put it back in. Some people like to keep it flat like this. Other people like to put some air in it to make sure that they get it all the way inside so you don't have any bubbles outside of it. So I like to put a little bit of air in it. I think it's a little bit easier to go ahead and put it in and to make sure that I don't have any pinches, especially with this tire because it is super, super tight. So again, I'm just gonna pump a little bit of air in here, if I can get it. That's what I talked about, having, get it all the way in. All right, there we go. A little bit, just enough to puff it up some, that's it. No more than that. Because the tube will extend, and that makes it too hard. Then you usually end up pinching it through. Okay. So you can see it's not twisted. It's really nice just laying here nice and flat. I have it in line with where my hole is on my rim to be able to put the valve back through. And again, this is a really, really tight tire. Bike tires will be a little bit easier. Something, if I have a tire that is always popping tubes, I will actually take the whole tire off and I will feel around this rim and make sure that there's nothing pointy. And many of them should have this rim tape in here that makes sure none of your spokes can pop up through and pop. So if you have a tire that's always popping, go ahead and take your tire all the way off and feel through and make sure that you don't have anything that's potentially sharp to be potentially always popping your tire. So this one is popping a lot, but I've checked it already and I'm not sure why it keeps popping. All right, the next fun part. So most important thing is you want to get that stem back in line so it's not twisted. So this, to make it a little bit easier, which I should have done in the first place, you can pull it back this way and tuck it all the way through. Then once you have it there, you bring it back forward and make sure that tube is nicely tucked in there, okay? So I wanna make sure that the stem isn't leaning one way or the other, that is really aligned. Now, I just go around and I just tuck in the tube inside the tire. You kinda wanna start pushing it into the up upper part to the rim. There you go. Nice. I always give it nice squeezes all the way around. That helps make sure that's really inside that tube. All right. Then always starting at your stem is where you tuck your tire in. Because this is the hardest part to make sure the tube doesn't bubble. Because right there, the tube sometimes gets stuck. And you want to make sure that you tuck your tire in there. That there's no tube getting pinched in between the stem and where you're putting the tire. So this is the hardest place here to really make sure that you're tucking this in place. So I'm just going to pinch it, start going around. Seems a very easy task. Wait till you get to the end. That's when it starts getting hard again. So again, I'm pinching and pulling and rolling the tube towards me to make sure the tube stays up here. And I'm looking down to make sure that there's no tube I see. So it doesn't get pinched or there's not a bubble once we blow it up that gets caught there. All the way through. This is when it's going to start getting really tight. So you do the best you can with your fingers trying to tuck it in there. Then you got to go back to your tools. And this time, instead of pulling it out where the actual divot is facing you, you're going to go the opposite way. And you're going to put this to the inside of the rim. And then pull it in there. Okay. So gets it in where it needs to be. Sometimes you have to do two at a time. This tire is super tight and cold, which makes it really difficult to do this. We'll see how long it takes me to do it. Might have to pause the video and come back when I have it in. Oh, I don't know. Might have some good luck. I'm gonna do the two tool. Almost. Again, if you can do a wheelchair, you can do a bike tire, no problem. Woo! There we go. The two tool technique worked. All right. Woo! We got it. So again, I always check, feel all the way around, really make sure that tube's tucked in, give it a nice good pinch down below. Feels really good. Everything's in. I don't see any tube sticking out, which means up top here. Then we get to pump it up. See how it goes. And again, trying to get your pump on the stem, you're going to want to squeeze it down here to make sure you don't push that stem back up. So I squeeze it. Shake, shake, shake. Really get it on. Let's see. Nice and easy, yeah. You can pump up a little bit, some will check again. But I usually just visually look for a bubble that's out. So if you're not able to, you wanna put your fingers right on the rim and feel to make sure it's nice and smooth, that there's no little bubble of your tube popping out. So you just take your fingers and run it all the way through your tube, both sides, and make sure nothing's sticking out. All right, once you're filled, don't forget that cap, which seems to always get lost in the process. Put that cap back on, then you're ready to reinstall your tire, all pumped up, ready to ride. All right, that was the A of air. We'll have two more videos, one for B for brakes, and then C for chain. Whew, good work.